Well, believe it or not, Library Director Barry Bradford has been busy even today in a meet where FEMA is at the main library. I imagine one of several things that you've been doing. First, what about FEMA coming to town?
Yes, FEMA has set up at the AMEET branch library in order to help people, to help facilitate people to apply for services and assistance. And they were there yesterday from 8 to 6, and they're here at AMEET branch again today from 8 to 6. We're providing restroom facilities and a space for them to be in out of the heat, out of the sun. So we had a lot of people come yesterday and even more today. We had over 100 lined up when they opened up this morning at 8 o'clock. So it's been well used.
So will this be going on in the week to come?
Well, I'm not sure yet. I have communicated with FEMA and asked them to please let me know where we can help and when we can help, and we'll have staff to allow people to use our buildings for, again, shade and restroom facilities and water. But I have not heard back as far as anything in the coming week. Right now, today is the last we know. So,
do you have power at any of the libraries?
We do not. We do have a generator at AMEET, but the generator, for whatever reason, failed to function, so we don't have power at any of our locations. None of our libraries are open to the public right now, and of course, a lot of my staff have evacuated, and they're scattered across the southeastern United States, but we will, as soon as we get power back and we can get our staff back in the buildings, we plan to reopen and provide as much service as we can.
And chances are the libraries will get electricity before most residences do, so they'll be very critical as a hub.
Yes, and that's the thing we're most concerned about, is being able to provide that kind of location where people can come, use the internet, have power. There's a lot of things the library can do for folks, facilitating, again, like things like FEMA applications for services and resources, and we can provide that if we have power and we can get our staff in there and open up.
You know, it's incredible to think that maybe a month from now, this will all be a distant memory.
Yes, I hope it's a distant memory in a month. I think it will be. We've had to postpone a couple of things, but we're anticipating getting power back in the parish, at least from, according to Energy, on the 17th of September. Right now, I have tentatively set the 20th is a reopen date. That may change. We may be able to get back in earlier. Hope so. But for right now, that's what we're going with for the moment. So hopefully we'll get power back before then and we can open up before then.
What about all the internet services offered by the library? Are they available?
Yes, they are, actually. Our website is up. We're hosted by a company out of Tangipahoa Parish. Our site is hosted on two different locations around the country. So, yes, you can get onto our website, use our electronic materials. They're there 24/7. So, yes, you can, even though you can't get to our physical materials, you can use all of our electronic materials.
And for those who are using their portable devices, their phones, maybe an iPad or whatever, stuck at home, this can be a godsend.
Yeah, absolutely. It can not only provide you with important information you might need, but also give you that entertainment that you're looking for when you and your kids have nothing to do at home. We've got ebooks, we've got movies, we've got all kinds of things that you can download on your phone if you've got any kind of internet access, which I think is coming back now. So sure, go to tangilibrary.com and take advantage of what we got there.
And you say internet, if you have good cellular data, you can also do the same thing.
That's correct. As long as you've got a phone that's got a connection with cell towers, then that will serve you well. I've taken advantage of it myself, so yes.
So I just don't want to lose sight of this, because there are people out there. Do you hear everybody that you can get a movie for free, you can get a book for free, you can get all kinds of stuff for free, you can even educate yourself for free if you just go to the Tangi Library website, which is tangilibrary.com?
Yes, sir. That's correct. We've got genealogy resources, movies, ebooks. You can learn a foreign language, all kinds of stuff that's available, and it is free. Your tax dollars have already paid for it, so please take advantage of it. It's yours.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, we are doing everything we can to serve the public in these limited circumstances that we're in. And as soon as we know if we're going to be working with FEMA at other locations or any kind of help provide any services anywhere else, we will post them on our Facebook site and on our website. So keep coming back and checking those sites, the library's site on Facebook and on our website, to know what we're doing, when we'll be doing it. So.